So the vast majority of patients with adrenal fatigue also have immune system problems. And this connection, right, between the immune system and the adrenals is often very misunderstood. People try to have this conversation about a chicken versus egg conversation, right? Is it the infections, right? Is it the Epstein-Barr? Is it the Lyme? Is it the mycoplasma? Is it my allergies or whatever, right, that causes the adrenal problems, or vice versa? So when I think about physiologically what happens, right, when our body is in a stress response, we know that that extra cortisol goes to the immune cells, and the immune system is all throughout the body. It's in the gut, it's in the brain, it's everywhere, right? That cortisol hits those cells and suppresses them. It suppresses them. It's not a clean suppression, and we know that that happens, right? It makes sense, right? Because you don't want to waste energy healing some inflammatory process when there's a tiger in front of you, right? You don't want to waste energy fighting some chronic infection when there's a tiger, right? Conserve that energy, right? And then once the tiger's gone, okay, now we can deal with some of that immune system stuff. It's not a clean suppression, like I said. Most often, it causes the immune system to go through a bit of a shift. Technically, we call that a Th1 to Th2 shift. Th just stands for a certain immune cell, T helper cells. See, immune cells, they start out as what we call naive immune cells, Th0. They haven't decided kind of what profession to take, I guess, if you want to think about it that way. The Th1 profession is the profession within the immune system that fights things inside cells. We call this a cellular, cell-mediated immunity. Fights inside cells like yeast and viruses and some intracellular bacteria, cancer even, right? That's Th1 immune function. Th2 fights outside cells, right? So this deals with mostly antibody production. So there's this phenomenon called the Th1 to Th2 shift. When cortisol hits the immune system, that naive, young Th0 cell has to decide a profession. It says, okay, I'm not going to Th1, I'm gonna go to Th2. So Th1 side gets suppressed and the Th2 side gets upregulated. When the Th1 side is suppressed, we are more vulnerable to infections, right? Epstein-Barr, Lyme, Candida, even cancers can come about because of this. What also will happen is the Th2 side gets upregulated, so we start overproducing antibodies to things, and now you can potentially develop allergies, right, to the environment, to foods, right? You can develop even autoimmune conditions can come about because of this. Now, not all patients have problems on both sides, right? Some people just the Th1 side vulnerability, and we'll see that. Some people the Th2 side, but there's plenty of people with both of these things. Now, there are things in nature that we can use to help re-regulate that, right? Things we can use to bring down the Th2, things we can use to bring up the Th1, which I will use. But first and foremost, we have to shift this physiology because the immune system is just behaving as it's been told. Right? That's what cortisol is telling the immune system to do. We have to change that message, right? Change that signal, remove that suppression, right? And that's when the immune system can finally improve. And that's when you can, you know, stop catching every little bug that comes your way or stop having your Epstein-Barr reactivate like mine did again and again and again, which I chased after for years. That's when allergies can actually go away, which can happen over time, right? So the immune system is a problem in my patients. And yes, if you're developing a chronic infection, is that a stress? Does that go in the bucket? Yes. Are allergies a stress? Is that in the bucket? Yes. You want to pay a little attention to that stuff, right? But the key, right? The key is to prevent, right? The key is to fix this physiologic suppression of the immune system, which is making you vulnerable to all those various things. We've got to stop chasing these secondary and tertiary dysfunctions that are really just the result of the adrenal fatigue. Fix the adrenal fatigue, right? Which is this whole stress response system being dysfunctional. You fix that, right? And then you can stop chasing after all this other stuff.